How can such bright children be such slow learners? Sometimes I really have to fight the impulse to be a lot more direct with my kids, rather than almost always sanding down the edges of most of the criticism I give them. Maybe they've done something just dumb or selfish, ignoring the critical wisdom I calmly dispensed about this very thing. And it's not the first time. I can feel my temper stepping on the gas. The top is down, a seductive ill wind blows through my hair, my scalp is tingling, a perfectly withering remark, brief and satisfying, rises to my lips. The brakes! Hit the brakes! I'll have to reserve that kind of self-indulgence for good friends and relatives old enough to defend themselves from my criticism, and who know me and themselves well enough to hear it with the proper acceptance or disdain. No, I must continue to make most criticism sound like a brilliant suggestion, and most praise like a revelation. Their egos are still transparent. I'm almost as frightened as they at the effect my unsubtle criticism can still have in a quivering lip or slumping shoulders. It's a dangerous power and can motivate only so long as it doesn't devastate. I make mistakes. My daughter says I say more about her few bad grades than about the many excellent ones. My son made a similar observation about coaching them at sports. And I've had to remind myself that the healthy growth of a human being is a marathon, not a sprint. On the other hand, I don't expect the kids to share my sense of the proper balance between praise that simply reinforces and constructive criticism meant to teach and motivate. And I won't be one of those fathers too worn out to do battle if that's what it turns into, or who thinks children need friends more than parents. And one day, if I walk the fine line, I'll feel free to treat my accomplished and confident children with the same loving acidity reserved for the successfully grown-up loved ones in my life. Look, doofus, I'll start being nicer if you start being smarter.